Welcome to the Simmons Bank Treasury Management Training Video Series. In this video, you will learn how to access the Lockbox service, change the project view, search for specific transactions, view and redact images of a transaction, export a PDF, download documents, review batch details, and manage users. Let's start with learning how to access the Lockbox service. To begin, navigate to the Simmons Bank website, select the Business tab, and then select the drop-down arrow. Next, select Lockbox from the drop-down menu. Click the Go button to access the Lockbox login screen. Next, enter your company ID and login credentials. When complete, click Login. You have successfully logged into the system. Now let's learn how to change your project view. Different projects can have different search criteria depending on how your Lockbox is configured. To change the project view, click the drop-down arrow. If you have access to only one project, it will already be selected. Next, select a different project. The search criteria changes per the configuration of the Lockbox project. In this example, we will switch back to a medical-related project. Now let's learn how to search for a specific transaction. You can search by a specific date or by a date range. When complete, click Search. The search results are displayed. Select an item in the search results screen to view the related documentation. If your project is configured to capture multiple index records, those items will be displayed in the Split Records section. In this example, the selected document is an explanation of benefits, and each patient index record is displayed in the Split Records section. Select a patient. The system will display the page of the document for this patient. If you would like to perform a different search, click Search Criteria to expand the section. First, clear the original search criteria. Next, we will search for a specific patient. First, enter the patient's name. Please note that you can place an asterisk at the end of an entry to search for all items beginning with those letters, but you must enter at least 3 characters. When complete, click Search. The search results are displayed. If you would like to see images related to the selected item, click the transaction arrow. Click the row to return to the original search results. Scroll to the bottom of the screen. In this example, we have selected a multi-page document. Options are available to control the images. Click the right arrow to view the second page. If you need to make changes to the image or place notes on an image, click the Redact button. The Item Annotations and Redactions screen is displayed. First, click the redaction icon. You can choose the redaction color if desired. In this example, we will continue to use white. Click an area on the document. A box is displayed that you can move to redact an area of the document. Please note, you can also resize the box. When complete, click Apply. Please note, even though the image is now redacted, this does not change what is stored in the online system. You can save this document as a PDF. You can also add a comment to the document by clicking the Add Text button. Simply enter the text and specify the font, font size, and color. Click the Close button if you do not wish to enter a comment. Now let's learn how to export the transaction to a PDF. First, click the Selected Item drop-down arrow. Choose the information you wish to capture. In this example, we will select all results. Next, choose the data elements and images you would like to include in the PDF. Please note that if the main data and details data options are checked, that information will be displayed after each image. When complete, click Export. All the transactions you have specified are displayed in the report. Now let's learn how to download documents. First, click the Downloads menu. Next, click the Download Extracts menu option. The most recent PDFs are displayed. Click on the file name or the green icon to begin the download process. In this example, once downloaded, we will open the document. The summary PDF displays and includes the total count of the different items in the batch and the batch total. Please note, this document can also be emailed by the bank once the deposit is made. You can also download a virtual batch PDF, which gives a listing of all check transactions in the batch, as well as the images for the batch. The images PDF shows the images associated with the EOB. Now let's learn how to review batch details. First, click the Reports menu. You can choose from Batch Detail Reports, Batch Summary Reports, or Activity Log Reports. Click the Batch Detail Reports menu option. Select a date range or select a defined date. In this example, we will run a report for the last 30 days. Next, click Report. The Batch Detail Report displays. Now let's learn how to manage users in the system. Please note, you must be an administrative user to manage users. To begin, click the Administration menu. Next, click Maintain Users. All users of the system are listed. To add a user, click the Add New User hyperlink. Enter the user ID, full username, and email address. Once created, the user ID cannot be changed. Within a company, each user must have a unique email address. Please note, the role will be users. You cannot create other administrators. In order to add, delete, or edit admin users, please contact us. Define the user's security, features, reports, and time restriction options. When complete, click Save. Select Send Email to send the employee their setup information. Select Copy to put the information on the clipboard. You can also edit, unlock, or reset the password of existing users. For more information about the Lockbox service, please contact us.